waiter, a Coke and a chicken salad, please. Thank you.
I beg your pardon, you got the time?
18 minutes past 6.
Well, I could have made a guess myself. There's too much trouble to one time to say so.
I have no need for such contrivances.
He guessed correctly. I have 20 after. I'm a little fast.
I can believe that.
You always tell time without a watch.
I once had a difference of opinion with a watchmaker. I boycotted timepieces ever since.
You couldn't be without this. It has great sentimental value.
A gift from your fiancé?
A former fiancé. My present fiancé gave me this. An engagement present. We're being married in a few days.
A good catch for the right girl.
And you've seen it. Oh, but you couldn't. He hasn't left his compartment since we've been on the train. He sits there and looks out the window, hour after hour. I don't know what he sees except telephone poles and dirt and farms and more telephone poles. It bores me terribly. Oh, I don't think I have no appreciation for the great Northwestminster.
Dr. Malonius.
How do you do? I'm Marie Kimball. The truth is, trains bore me. Nothing ever happens. Nothing to do except look out the window. It's so monotonous. You get on a train in one place, and the engine humps and puffs and lets you off in another. It takes so much time and wastes so much time.
I find the trip particularly exciting. This is the first time I've traveled this route.
The first time is always exciting, no matter what one does.
We're approaching a curve at high speed. That nail file, the point is sharp.
So?
You might hurt one of those pretty fingers.
Oh! You're a doctor. I need some doctoring.
Degree is honorary. I don't practice medicine.
My poor finger. You told me this was the first time you'd been over this route. How did you know we're approaching a curve?
I warned you in time.
I never listened to warnings. Besides, I'm glad it happened. Anything to break this monotony. I'm too forceful. Perhaps I'm too stubborn to listen to warnings. When I do listen, in one ear, out the other.
That isn't good. I could tell you of a forceful woman. She knew what she wanted and thought she knew how to get it.
Sounds like me. She was warned of some danger?
Yes. She was on a train. She was warned to stay on it, but in one ear, out the other. As the train pulled into the town of Clayburgh, it was after 9. The station was deserted, except for a man. He was a man trying to lead a simple, happy life. He found out life was neither simple nor happy. The girl who was warm, made his life complicated and miserable.
You can't get me like a coward!
Thank you.
big bundle on the train. Oh, it's sticky. You ought to see a doctor. Or Doc Arnold. We had that in the post office. Sure, the heart of blood. Maybe you'd better tie it up. Make a tourniquet. She doesn't want me to come down and watch the trains at night. Don't say anything. Come here. Let's hide in here. Why'd you put that bundle on the back of the train? The baggage car's for bundles. The back of the train is for people. Something's gonna happen to me. I'm too big to be treated like a baby. She's always telling me how I'm gonna be carried home as a broken something. I'm gonna be home before she does. Sorry, I can't help with that tourniquet. Go see Doc Arnold. Bye.
Bridge washed out up ahead. Can't get through that way. Hop in. Maybe we can get through on 77.
Going far?
No, not far.
Lucky thing for you, I came along. I had to cover the news about the bridge. Otherwise, I'd have been in bed long before now. Clay Burke, I'm the reporter, publisher, and editor. One-man organization. McPhee. First thing, they knock the driver over the head, take his money, car. Way to go.
How far are we going?
I don't know. Didn't know if we were still on 77.
We weren't on 77 at all. Guess it looks thing, this is Clayburg.
Well, there were a couple of roads washed out, so I just turned around and kept on driving.
I should have stayed awake and drove himself. Can I get you staying up late? I got enough news about the flood anyway. Staying here? Can't go anywhere else.
Where's the hotel?
Hotel. Get in. Tell Mrs. Mitchell McPhee sent you. An old friend.
Thanks for the lift.
Didn't get you very far. You get out tomorrow, all right, maybe.
Well, good night.
Good night.
Said you have a room.
I have a room, but it's not for rent.
Oh, I'm sorry. The fee said...
You want to see Mrs. Mitchell. Maybe she has a room. Come on. Aunt Thelma! You get washed out by the river?
Yeah.
This town is washed out any way you look at it. Aunt Thelma, can you come here a minute?
I haven't got a cold. Tommy? Well, he hasn't sneezed once. Don't you think he should just go to bed? I'm not going to have a sick boy on my hands. Oh, no, you don't. You can stay here and have your throat sprayed. Open. Kickle!
Now, Michael, you stay right here and look up, while I promise you were thinking out to watch the train.
I did not.
You tell lies now and you grow up to be a bandit. If you didn't go to the railroad station, where were you? All right. I won't do anything until I know the truth. But if you've been lying, oh boy, will you get it.
This man said McPhee sent him for a room. He's washed out.
Oh, that's too bad. But if you're a friend of McPhee's, I guess we can find a room for you.
This is Mrs. Mitchell.
Don't laugh. Harold, don't laugh.
How do you do? I'm Jean Maxwell.
Hello.
Now, where in the world will I put you? Well, good night. I'm going to bed. To read.
Good night, darling. Oh, I know. Just go upstairs. First door to the left. And take a towel out of the linen closet. Just keep opening doors till you find it. It's there somewhere. Oh, my goodness. You get all those wet clothes, room. We'll have you under vapors, too. Come down later for a cup of tea. My goodness, you... You won't have anything to come down in, will you? I'll get you a pair of Willie's work pants. They should fit you, and he won't mind. He's out now piling up sandbags at the river.
Himself. I'll get the bed.
eaten up a park.
You stingy old nincompoop.
Oh, give me a can of this.
I won't give you nothing.
Just a measly can.
I ain't gonna give you nothing. This ain't good enough for you. You go and get yourself a case of bourbon and hide it good.
You know I had a hide it. Mrs. Mitchell doesn't approve of drinking on the premises.
Oh, she doesn't, huh? Well, listen, if we want a can of beer, who's gonna stop us? Besides, Mrs. Mitchell and me is just like that. Yes, sir. And anything I want to do, I do. Now, for instance, if I want to get myself a cold piece of chicken out of the refrigerator, digital, the ice box, I take it. Whenever I want to do something, it's okay. You know, she knows that I'm not feeling well around here. I'll move just like her. You only know how to pull parts out of bourbon bottles. This is a man-sized job. You want to know something? I can push the old girl around like a little bit of thing. You want to know how?
How?
Flatter her. Tell her she's beautiful.
Can't you use clever without being a big liar?
Look, bud. When you tell a woman that's over 40 that she's beautiful, you ain't a liar. You're a philanthropist. I know how to handle women. Nothing to her. Don't interrupt. Women are women.
Mrs. Mitchell?
Yes, Mrs. Mitchell, too. I've worked here so long. I cracked the phone before. All right, go ahead. Have a care, and I think I'll have a more ball later.
Did you get that way falling into the river?
No, Miss Mitchell. Well, we just had one each. And we got a lot left over. I won.
What?
Oh, we really worked hard, Miss Mitchell. The river's up 2 feet more than it was. Gosh, it's awful. Oh, it's really terrible. Kind of like a nightmare.
All right, William. Go to bed.
Thank you.
Pardon me. I thought you were the cat. Going down by the river? You look like someone.
Everyone looks like someone. Yeah, I'm going down the river. Want to come with me? Come on. We can watch together. Maybe we'll give them a chance to see the river overflowing. It's pretty exciting.
Sleep?
Not yet.
I don't like to sleep. Boy, think of all the things I could be doing right now. If it wasn't for my mother, she doesn't let me have any fun. Like watching the trains down at the station. You know, you look like someone I saw the other night. You won't tell my mother I was at the station. That's the doubt.
I wasn't at the station.
Oh, anyway, you know I was. My mother knew. I wouldn't get my allowance for 6 months. I'd get a walloping, too. I don't like being walloped. Gee, trains are wonderful. Especially at night. They're like big, long snakes with lighted skins. And they whistle and smoke and rattle. Boy, there's something.
When was it you saw at the station?
Oh, just a man. He put a bundle with something on the train. And I guess he hurt his arm. Must have cut it.
Is that why you were watching me take my shirt off?
I was just wondering. Not many people come to Claiborne. And you're the only stranger. I mean, person who's new around here.
Still want to see my arm?
Nah. Wouldn't make any difference anyway. I wonder if you were the same man.
Where? I wasn't anywhere near the station tonight. I hitched a ride to Claiborne. Remember that?
Sure, but nobody...
Look. And a scratch on it. Nothing on that one either.
Yeah, fine, but I was more...
I never travel on trains. I like to watch them, but not ride them. I don't even know where the station is.
Yeah, well, there's nothing wrong with being there. Unless there's someone like my mother who doesn't want you to go.
The first time we saw each other was in the park.
Sure, in the park. Yeah, And I was lucky you found me before my mother did. You said meet me, shall I? I'm sure lucky you came to claim me. Say, why don't we sneak out now and go down by the river? Okay, I'm getting sleepy anyway. Good night. What's your name?
Harold.
Good night, Harold.
Orchard Street. Of course. Down near the paper mill.
I'm full. Can I go out now? You go out on the porch and stay on the porch. If you put one foot...
Okay, Mom. I'll stay right on the porch. I won't even put one toe on.
Close the windows! They're coming through the door! Hi, Missy.
Well, this little Lord Fauntleroy's bad brother.
Morning, Missy.
Morning.
Come in, sit down.
The morning good and impractical.
You're late, Missy. The coffee's lukewarm.
That's just the way I like it. Morning, sweetheart.
Hiya, Whisper.
Don't call me that. Hi. Didn't steer you wrong, did it?
Oh, thanks very much. Couldn't have done better anywhere. What about the flood? Not any worse than that.
Same. Bridge is out. They tried to put up a pontoon affair, but didn't last long. You can be able to get out around dinner time. Trains can't get through either. Bad thing happened on the Limited last night.
Another break? I just knew the Limited would do something like that. I've worn Michael 100 times.
Calm down. Nothing was wrecked. Except a girl.
It can happen to anybody. This magazine's full of things like that.
Got it on the wire this morning. Some girl got herself killed on the Limited. Found her on the rear platform. Nail pipe. Like that. Might be the heart.
Somebody drew her in?
They weren't cleaning her nails.
What did happen?
Don't know yet. Somewhere up around Seattle they found the body.
I should hear about this. Maybe this will stop him from running down that railroad station.
Mrs. Bennett. Let me tell you. Mike and I are pretty friendly. There's no sense in scaring the boy.
He should be scared. I'm scared when he's out alone in the North Square. If scaring will scare him, he should be scared.
I'll tell him. I think he'll behave himself.
You don't know that boy very well, do you? Full of mischief. Need some discipline.
That's what he needs, all right. He needs a father.
Got to go. Wait for me. Nice to meet you, Donna.
I'll give him a good talking to, just like a big brother.
Make sure you're scared. Very sweet man. Very sweet.
Take it easy, dearie. He offered to be Mike's big brother, not his father.
I'll just ignore all that remark.
Come on, Mike.
Hi.
like?
Your mother's on a warpath.
It's nothing new.
I just thought I'd tell you. I know you've been at high for a while.
What have I done now? Holy cow. She's always after me for something.
She'll calm down, but maybe you better beat it.
Nah, that'll make her madder.
She'll get over it, don't worry. I doubt she sees you now.
I'd better stay right here on the porch.
Well, I can't do what you like. Stay here.
I don't like staying here.
If you don't like it, don't do it. Listen, I'll bet you know lots of places where you could have more fun than sitting here twiddling your fingers.
Sure. I know a lot of places. Down by the river, or near the railroad tracks, or the park. Gosh, I sure would like to shimmy up one of them big trees. I could see the whole town, and the tracks, and river, and everything, on top of a tree.
Why don't you go?
My mother'd find out. She's got something magic about her. Why she finds out everything?
No, she'll cool off later.
Sometimes she boils for days.
Here, you get yourself something you'll want for dinner. Lots of candy. Anything you like.
No, I'd really catch it.
I think your mother will tell her about the station.
Did you tell her?
Of course not.
Thanks. You're a pal.
Better wait after dinner.
Okay. I'll do the same for you someday.
Okay, Mike.
You make the best coffee this side of Brazil, Elmer.
Sorry, the tea was a hot empty.
In that case, I'll run along back to the shop.
You couldn't have done a good job that quickly.
The boy of yours won't come to the French again. I give it some good. Come here, let me take
this. Oh, thank you.
You don't spoil things around here for me, Elmer. I'd a good mind to not work on the bridge myself and get you out of here faster.
I wish you would. I'm going to leave today.
Maybe you can. But here's the thing I'm calling you.
Bye, all.
Bye, McPhee. See you later.
Why, James, what happened to you? You just don't like to do things you're expected of me, that's all. I can do it myself when I'm in the mood.
Well, the nicest thing I ever heard. Oh, I won't say another word. I'll catch up on my book.
What book are you reading?
None. But I've read so many,
and they seem so easy.
I decided to write for myself.
Maybe it looks right.
Not. How could you tell?
Same as all the others, and I do admit it.
A girl's a girl. Oh, I talk like I'm wise, Steph. Truth is, I'm this way because of some guy. It all happened 2.5 long years ago. Guess I'm about over it by now. I was sweet and gay, and madly in love. Sun shined every day, the moon flashed out. Then one day I found a note. Darling, this is goodbye. I'm going back. My wife. The jerk was me. married, I didn't know. What's with you now? We're old friends. Tell me all.
Who, what?
Why are you running away? The girl you live with. The one you said was like me. Does she spend all your dollars?
Yeah. She spent all my dollars. I didn't care. Then one day I found out a few things.
A switch. She was married and she left you alone.
Well, she wasn't married. I left her. Yes. I don't know why. It happened. Everything's fine. Just a few days ago, I thought she was supporting some other guy.
You just ditched her, huh? That dame on the train that McPhee mentioned. She got it good. Paid for a lot of others. Wonder what she did that deserves such a happy end. Probably took some guy like you over the coals and he didn't like it. Try that again sometime. Without the tone.
You're well off now. Don't look for trouble.
Excuse me. I forgot the bills I brought home last night. Nobody likes stuff with me. So I might as well take it out of the place with me. Nobody will be in for gas. Nothing to do with it.
Don't apologize, Willie. You want your beer, take it.
Okay?
No, thank you.
That's enough.
Oh, well, my friend might drop in.
Yeah, I know. You don't care who you share your beer with. Last night, I heard you offered some to Mike.
Well, I didn't know what I was doing. What's the matter with that kid, anyway? I saw him outside, and I told him what I heard on the radio, and he acted like I was chasing him with a gun.
What did you hear, Uncle Bull Bill?
The news! About that girl that was murdered on the train last night. The police up in Seattle think she was murdered between here and lunchtime. Sure you want to have a can? Excuse me again.
Something to be hanging around here.
Oh, cut it out. You were a boy once yourself, McPhee. Why don't you let him help you run your press? After all, somebody has to take over when you get old and fat. You...
All right. All right, I'll keep you here at dinner time. Am I invited to dinner? Okay. Listen, the road's still washed out. Tell that man. Bye.
Things, think them. Got something to say, say it.
Feel like a game of checkers? I just knew you were a checker fiend. Something about you to get you away. Which do you want, red or black? Can't play standing up. Ladies first.
way. Playing against myself.
Don't kid yourself. That's the best way to lose. Fight yourself, and the part that wins doesn't count. It's the part that loses.
I have a short memory. One time I lose, the next time I win. Sort of balances the books. You know, you've been in this bread less than a full day. I've been here 2.5 years. Question. Which one of us is more anxious to leave? You, me, or both of us? You know, I tried working once. I could maybe try it again.
It's a real nice thought. Real nice.
I could get my old job back in San Francisco.
All right, why don't you? I've never seen the government get it. When you get there, send me a picture postcard.
That's what I send.
You will be going?
That all depends on you.
Don't depend on me, honey. Not me.
Harold. I've been doing some thinking. Without even trying. You better do some thinking, too.
She's just covering up for him, that's all. And if she did tell you to go, what right is she doing?
I told Mark to go, not you.
You told me.
Didn't you say something?
Has he come back yet?
No, but if you send him somewhere, I guess it's all right.
No, I didn't send him anywhere. I just told him to go. I shouldn't have. You're very right to be strict with him. Why, he's liable to go down to the river. Maybe hurt himself. Might even fall in deep water.
I worry too much. He'd always come right back to now. He'd be all right. Would you like to try a game of checkers?
No, thanks. I've tried one.
Harold. McPhee just called. Mike's with him. They'll be home for dinner.
Don't tell me. Oh, no. I'm only his mother.
Been thinking?
All done.
Wait a minute. The roads are still washed out.
Still they're washed out.
The bridge is still down, too. Takes more than a day to build another.
Look, if you go, where are you going to go? You've got to stay.
You've got nothing to run away from. Except me.
Thank you.
right here and keep Mr. Dunlap company. This time we're going to stay until late last night.
I want to go down with you.
You big day, you must come over you. I'll get you something to meet for the morning.
Michael,
I'll
be. Thanks very much, Miss.
You're welcome. If you need anything, Mike will get it for you.
Stairs. You want to tell anybody anything? Call them up here. I'd like a chance to hear about it too. You're not sure, Mike. You know how it feels when you want to think you've done something and you really haven't? You sure have some proof.
Someone put that girl on the train. There was blood on your sleeve.
I wasn't cut.
The girl was. Besides, where's your suit? Show me the suit if it wasn't you.
What was it all? Well, here, I'll get it for you.
Let me lean on your
you wanted me to nurse you instead of mine. Is that why you let him run off again?
Yeah, I didn't want to be alone with you for a few minutes.
It would have been so simple. All you had to do was walk to my room. If it was empty, you could have waited. You're not done, Paul. I'm not done either. Something's brewing. You planning to leave?
Yeah. Water everywhere, and not a drop to drink.
That's why you all dressed for bed. In your suit.
Doesn't it rot with
the mic? That's a pretty good reason for changing your clothes. Or would you like to try again? I don't suppose you heard the news. In about a half an hour, the highway's going to be open. Mm-hmm. A couple of men with badges, notebooks, handcuffs are coming here to talk with the state police. You know, I'm a little more suspicious than coming from a small town. You did something. And I think I don't believe it.
All my life I've been attracted to the wrong kind of girl.
You're thinking of leaving, forget it. You're going to stay right here in Clayborough for the time being. For me. No one saw you get on or off the train. You were free.
Well, if anyone's seen you.
Who saw you? If they can identify you, you're finished. You can't touch him, do you hear? Some women get what they want. But you can't kill a kid. You're pretty old. You're even too bad for me. I don't know what you're planning to do, but I won't let you do it.
You're very pretty. Those lips aren't moving.
Yelling at the back?
No. See him?
That's him. Get him. You can run faster than I can. Got good news for you. The road's open.
Mike!
Carol just run after Mike. We got him spotted.
That's right. Somebody's able to run. Did you say Harold? Ran after Mike?
Like a deer. Well, when I was young, I used to...
Harold's ankle is sprained. He could be locked in his room.
Girl. He knows I saw him dump her on the train. He tried to kill me. Oh, oh good heavens. He's here in the park.
Let's see. How can a big man like you move so quietly?
Rubber heel. See, you found Mike. Couldn't catch up with Harold. He was running like blazes.
Harold, kill him.
You see, something might have happened to you. I won't go out again, Ma.
Kill. Tell me something quick. What's going on? I'm the newspaper.
Come on, Steve.
I know, but tell me something. All my readers depend on the bulletin for the latest news.
Come on, I'll tell you on the
way. I know the traffic.
got our act together.
We should stay on the train. She'd be alive and I'd be afraid of her. First coast from Seattle. We should be here soon.
They'll be here.
Stop.
We're going to stop soon. Don't get off.